In the mind of a tech profiler, as a developer, a data scientist, you're always thinking, can I use that tomorrow?
And it might fail big time, but that is the whole fun of it, right?
Everyone in the team develops this urge to solve problems. It's some sort of addiction.
What makes the Agile way of developing very particular is that speed is part of the culture. And you can see that, for example, in our release cycles.
You know, just try small, put it out there ASAP, talk to people, let your ideas touch the ground. And if it doesn't work out, it's fine.
Another thing of the Agile way of developing is, of course, the scalability. You know, we design for 20x. It just means that what it works today has to work for like 20 times more. In our case, it's volume, data volume. That's why we need big data platforms. That's why we need to think always in algorithms that can scale.
So 20x is really a process that you go through and not something that you design from the start.
So how can we make sure that tasks that cost a lot of time from us today will be automated in the near future?
We build everything ourselves because we want to have ownership of what we build.
The funnest part of working for RDN is really in being involved in merchant-facing projects, where you really realize that, okay, what you are doing actually solves real tangible problems for our merchants.
The things we could do with data, for example, to help out our merchants, we have this system that forecasts at any point in time all the volumes of our merchants. And if we see an anomaly happening, then we know before our merchants that they have a problem.
There is always a gap between what they need and what RDN can offer, and that gap is what the implementation manager management team is meant to do. If you're basically a full stack developer that is that happens to be managing the merchant project, it might involve, you know, building maybe a certain component within a cash register or hosting part of the merchant infrastructure for them.
What I really like is when I see a lot of people at one desk trying to solve one problem that's really hard to solve. Everyone is bringing their analytical skills and their knowledge from other types of topics to make sure that we can provide the best answer.
If you have an idea, that idea will be challenged. You can just go quickly through the floors and I just ask, like, who can help, who can give me a feedback.
So I think usually a regular support team is hidden somewhere in the basement maybe, but this team is really in the middle of the office. Everyone knows where to find technical support, sometimes a little bit too often, but I think that's good.
You have to develop in rather unorthodox ways, and it doesn't really matter what other people say about how you should do it. You really just have to believe and trust your intuition.
Just by being a data scientist, you're not only a data scientist. You have a lot of room for experimentation. For me, it was very unusual to have this trust from day zero already.